Sorry, Telly. That's the consequence of being naughty. Okay, Mommy.
Disney fans, it is Disney Dan here with another episode of Distory, a Disney history lesson. And in this episode, we're going to take a look back at another evolution of the costume character, the one and only famous Queen Mouse, Miss Minnie Mouse herself.
Minnie Mouse! Minnie Mouse!
Both in and out of the parks. To start, we're going to go back to 1934, where Minnie was first seen in a issue from November. Mr. Santa Claus himself at the Conn's department store for a big Christmas promotion. It was a few years later at the Snow White premiere in 1937 that we get a peek at Minnie Mouse walking the red carpet with Mickey and Donald in a very unique all-fabric, cone-shaped, interesting-looking costume. Now, this was what looks like just the plush toy at the time, scaled up and turned into a pattern for a human outfit. So the cone-shaped head, the flower pot with the flower coming out, the little dress, the big white gloves, kind of looked like the toy Minnie just kind of brought to life for a human to wear. In 1949, we saw the partnership with Walt Disney and the Ice Capades to bring Disney on Ice and its characters around the country in a big ice skating spectacular. Now, this was a totally redesigned kind of foam and fleeced fabric head that had some interesting kind of cuts and gashes in the face in order to give the performers some visuals in order to just kind of see when they're ice skating. Costume on the body, however, didn't really change all that much, with a skin-tight black suit, white gloves, and the whole works. 1955, of course, everyone knows that Walt Disney didn't have any costume characters to roam around the park, so he reached into the Ice Capades and borrowed a few of their outfits, which we had just seen a few seconds earlier, and this is now Minnie and Mickey from the Ice Capades running around without ice skates in the parks. Now, a few changes have happened to these characters, including the addition of some more vision holes, quote-unquote, in the masks, and so those few simple gashes turn into some much larger, more horrific kind of looking gashes, made it kind of a little terrifying to see them in these photos. It was 1958 when the Disney Corporation decided to rebuild these characters into some costume versions for themselves to use in the parks, and not use the escapade versions, and they put the kind of the vision, the peeking holes out in the pupils of the characters instead of having those big gashes all over the face. Minnie had a big red bow across her chest, a little light pink bow on her head, some white five-finger gloves, some very flat shoes, and then, of course, the iconic skirt with the bloomers visual underneath. It was 1959 when Minnie got a complete redesign for the opening of New Tomorrowland, which we can see here in this photo, utilizing a big hard head instead of a soft foam head. Now, their bodies kind of stayed the same in that it was a black skin-tight suit. Minnie, of course, had a big blue bow, big blue dress. She continued to use flats, kind of like little blue flats, not character shoes. And her head had a nice little blue bow on top of it. Sometimes it didn't. And it kind of looked really pretty. It was essentially Mickey's head just redesigned to look more ladyish. 1962, though, brought, of course, one of the most interesting looking characters, the big head Minnie body design. Now, this was to give the characters a more cartoony look inside the parks instead of a more human figure, but it was not very well received by park guests and kids with constant complaints because the arms weren't usable. In fact, all the head and the torso of the performer was up inside this big rubber head, kind of stuck inside of it, and really couldn't interact with the characters and kind of got a ton of complaints. 1960 is where we got the kind of common Minnie that we're all very familiar with the right proportions and designs. Now, this common Minnie, quote-unquote, had a couple of costume redesigns over the years, going from Steamboat Minnie, which we just saw, to Yellow Dress Minnie in 1969, to eventually Polka Dot Minnie in 1977. While they all stayed the same head, the costume underneath the head, of course, the body, the shoes, the gloves, would change and change over the years, going from design to design, really evolving, depending on whatever the style was at the time. The 1977 polka dot look was the last costume look that utilized this head before the body itself was redesigned entirely in 1978. So this is kind of the last.
Like watching a two-year-old.
Redesigned in 1978. Now this was, of course, the big redesign that kind of secured and
1978.
Kind of modern mini look that we're all familiar with. They dropped that kind of skin-tight bodysuit and replaced it with a kind of padded, foamed, more character-appropriate suit. And so Minnie and Mickey got hips, Minnie got a little bit of a chest plate, some shoulder pads, kind of gave the body a more filled out. And so it didn't look exactly like a human stuck inside of a costume. It kind of had its own unique proportions.
Oh, no!
Nice. And on top of that, Minnie got some eyeshadow, some really pretty lashes. Her polka dot outfit kind of got secured in this decade, and it was a really cool look altogether. It was 1988 that gave Minnie some individuality finally, in that she received
the modern Minnie, 1988! That's the year when my older brother Anthony was born.
She kind of looked more quote unquote feminine. So her nose shrunk down, her eyes were put closer together, given different kind of eyelashes, higher eyebrows, just everything was shrunk down and changed to be uniquely Minnie. Then a few years later, in the early 2000s, that unique head sculpt became articulated.
Wow.
And now as the talking characters. And so now, when Minnie was out performing with all the other various characters in the show, she was allowed to lip sync.
She is pretty. That's just so pretty.
Feel that made it feel alive. I really, really was incredibly impressed when they finally did this. Then in 2016, at Shanghai Disney's opening, we saw
2016.
Which gave her much more oval, taller eyes, higher eyebrows, more of a rounded face. Now, this was a pretty big controversial redesign. A lot of people really, really hated it. But hey, I think it looks great. I think it looks like more cartoony and more fun. And then it finally made its way into an articulated...
Wait, which will be in theaters this February?
Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair and the Castle Show outside of Magic Kingdom in Disney World. All in all, I think it's a pretty cool look.
Goofy wants to be your friend.
There you go. There is the mini evolution over the past 50 plus years.
Wow.
From fabric head to foam gashed head.
Wow.
To hard plastic fiberglass head. And then to that awesome latex rubber articulated head that can talk and interact. Hope you guys enjoyed all of these character evolution videos. I really appreciate all your support. Leave me a comment to let me know what your favorite version of Minnie is and what character you want me to do next in the next Disney evolution video. As always, I appreciate you subscribing, so please subscribe, support, leave comments, like, share it.
Yes, sir.